Welcome to Whiskey.com, where fine spirits meet. My name is Lüning, Horst Lüning, and I'm the master taster of Whiskey.com. And today, this is a bottle I like from the paper specification. It's a Glendronach Vintage 1995, 19 years old, cask strength 55.8% ABV, and fully matured in Pedro Ximenez sherry casks. Cask strength, the wonderful distillery character of Glendronach and Pedro Ximenez sherry casks. What's the difference between Pedro Ximenez sherry and Oloroso sherry? Well, the sherries are typically fortified wines, means that you add brandy to the sherry to increase the ABV above the amount the yeasts are able to produce. They typically stop at 14-15%, and then you add brandy to bring it up to 20% or whatever specification the particular sherry has. But the Pedro Ximenez, this is stopped quite early in the fermentation process when the ABV isn't really high, so that there is residual sugar, fruit sugar from the grapes still in the sherry. And then you add brandy up to the 20%, so that you have a lot of sugar, residue sugar in this sherry. And this is the difference to an Oloroso, where you stop the maturation very, very late and add less brandy, so the Oloroso sherry is more fruity, and the Pedro Ximenez sherry is more sweet and fruity. And this is a perfect harmony for a good whiskey. This costs about 100 euros, and this is, yes, quite cheap for such a bottle. Close to 20 years old, 100% Pedro Ximenez sherry cask. Good price. Appearance, rich crimson flecked with gold. For me, this is dark mahogany. Yeah. And gold? No. Nose, chocolate and sweet dates, dusted with cinnamon sugar. I like cinnamon. In former times I had, when I was a child, we had cinnamon sugar over, yes, fermented milk. And when the parents didn't look, we took a full spoon of the cinnamon sugar. When the sugar was gone, the cinnamon was quite spicy. So pure cinnamon is quite spicy. Cinnamon sugar developed to rich, leathery notes of nutmeg and clove with the warmth of red chili. Red chili? Well, might come from the cask. 19 years in cherry cask and in European oak might bring sharpness. Palate, a heavily sherried character loaded with dark prunes and trickle toffee. An avalanche of vibrant orange bitters, dark espresso and fresh ginger give a contrasting crispness to the rich traditional finish. Billy Walker, master distiller. Yes, of course. Wonderful. A sweet, fruity aroma, which is immediately followed by more intensity, vanilla, toffee, the dates, chocolate, and oranges. Yes, this little bitterness of orange peel. Well, and cloves. Not a bouquet of cloves, but those spicy cloves, which you put to Christmas into the oranges. Nutmeg, I'm not quite sure, no. Wonderful, intense, complex, equally distributed between distillery character and the cask influence. I would have suggested more cask. Probably this is sherry cask from American oak, which matures not that bitter, not that spicy. Incredible. So wonderful, sweet, sherry, mouth-watering, spiciness appearing. No red chili, no normal spiciness, which carries longer. And now the dark espresso appears. A hint of bitterness, not much. The Pedro Jimenez brings, yeah, the sweetness is gone, but the fruitiness and it's weakening the spiciness. A wonderful balance between the aroma and the taste. And the aftertaste is full and long, still carrying the oakiness and the sherry and the oranges. Oh, the oranges typically from the distillery character, the sherry from the sherry, well, and the spiciness from the oak. Wonderful. This whiskey is close to perfect. This whiskey is the best whiskey in the world, from my point of view. No, this whiskey might be the best one I had this year. There are still a few to come, yes, but this one is close to the best. Wonderful. Oh, don't spoil a drop. So I'm afraid this whiskey is only available in Central Europe. No, it won't be available in other countries in the world, or in other continents in the world, but Glendronach issues a lot of vintages and single cask whiskies. And this one is a batch of casks, 4, 5, 6, I'm not quite sure. And it's a wonderful representation of the art of Glendronach. Thank you for watching whiskey.com. There's more to come. Stay tuned and feel free to share this video with your friends.